As we go to air tonight, one of the world's most remarkable rescue missions is underway. These are live pictures from the San Jose mine in Chile, where for the past 69 days, 33 miners have been trapped some 600 metres below the surface. And at exactly 11 minutes past two this afternoon, the first man was slowly and carefully winched to freedom.
A moment marking one of the greatest survival stories ever witnessed. Miner Florencio Avalos emerged into the night air for the first time in more than 2 months. The world watched enthralled, no one, though, happier than his tearful son. Embraced by his wife, rescuers and Chile's president, Avalos was considered the fittest and so was chosen to go first. Wearing specially designed sunglasses to protect his eyes after so long underground, Avalos was ushered to a triage centre for initial medical checks. The jubilation of this moment followed a day of delays as the exit capsule was checked and rechecked. Finally, mining rescue expert Manuel Rodriguez stepped into the capsule. A tap for luck and the cylinder, barely broader than a man's shoulders, was lowered in. A rescue so anticipated was finally underway. In a makeshift area dubbed Camp Hope, the families of the 33 miners waited anxiously, as they had for so long, but this would always be the longest day. 15 minutes after starting his descent 623 metres into the earth, rescuer and miners met. After nearly 2.5 months, their first physical contact with the world above. Manuel Rodriguez briefed the 33 men on what would happen next as the president carried the prayers of a nation and tens of millions across the globe. Each rescue takes about an hour. In the capsule, the miners have oxygen and they're constantly monitored.
Blood pressure will display here, heart rate, breathing rate.
And you'll be looking at the figures as they come up, I guess.
Correct. I'll be working with the doctors to make sure they interpret the data correctly.
The order of the miners' retrieval was carefully considered. While Florencio Avalos was first, last will be shift foreman Luis Azua. Credited with keeping the men alive in the first 17 days, they were cut off from the outside world. Already, experts who've spent a lifetime examining the effects of trauma say most of these men will recover quickly, but some might crack when the joy of release gives way.
Someone who is far more vulnerable will find that, mentally speaking, they still seem to be down in the mine. The memories come back so easily and so overwhelmingly.
Each miner will spend at least 2 days under observation in hospital, but for these men, the best medicine is freedom. This one even brought mementos from his time in captivity and a jubilation that's simply impossible to disguise. Eddie Meyer, 10 News.